represented. We have the brothers in white who represent the Muslim Brotherhood that Malcolm was a part of. They represent it symbolically because Malcolm was a part of a brotherhood. Just to know that the sisters have to be a part of the sisters. The men train the men, the women train the women. We come together as a family to raise our children. After the brothers are white, the sisters come. I mean, the children come. After the children, the sisters. The brothers surround the family, and the new Black Panther for self-defense takes care of the logistics on the ground. That is the order of the program. Just give us a few minutes, and the procession will begin.
Thank you. I'm gonna go get some more. Thank you. Have the five killers learn what they are.
They have to do with value, how to treat each other and to treat your God. In Christianity, we have the Ten Commandments and the theory of resurrection, which came from ancient chemists.
That's right.
Where Osiris rose. We have a belief in God supreme. And the Kemetic people called God supreme Ra. And Ra had many manifestations.
That's right.
And so that Djibouti is Jesus Christ. Remember I said that.
That's right.
Right.
Is the word of God that went forward. So that in John, when they said the word became flesh, that's what they're talking about. So I say to you that there's unity in our religions because we all believe in the Most High. Our ancestors never said that God was dead. And so that you, in your body, in your mind, must learn to worship the Most High. No child is too small to learn who God is and communicate with God. Because the special body that you were created with is one that allows you to know who your God is. So we have respect for all races, all people, all creeds. We in our understanding, even the Buddhists will say there are five precepts. And what are they? Let me stop, Jay. Five precepts. The Buddhists will say that there should be no lying, false speech. Everywhere in the media, all around us, we're hearing lies.
Yeah, that's
we
right.
Hear
right.
False speeches. We tell lies. Buddha said, no lie. It says, no destroying of human life, which means no killing in the Ten Commandments. Islam don't believe in killing people who are not part of the righteous brotherhood, the kingdom of God. And so then you have the idea of no intoxicating beverages, no drugs. No dealing with illusions that are bad for you, which includes you cannot listen to all illusions on televisions that are music or movies. You have to discipline yourself with illusions. No sexual promiscuity, whether it's adults trying to destroy our young boys, touching you where you should not be touched. This is the message, not of me, but of those that are sitting here, saying that you are not to be touched improperly in your sexual organs.
That's right.
That's the message from us, purity, to you young people. Why do we give you these messages? Because we love you.
Yes.
We love you. Raise your hand, all you. Never let it be said that your people did not love you.
Right.
The message of Malcolm X today to you is beware of the fox and don't run from the fox and fall in the hands
of the wolf.
What would be the coyote?
That's right.
The message from Malcolm X is to continue the generations and continue your moral values. God loves you.
There's a lot of people today are safe to ally yourself with Malcolm, but there are those revolutionary figures who I've known for over 45 years, who was with Malcolm and never stopped struggling a single day since Malcolm left as a revolutionary leadership. And one of our elders and leaders, Brother Herman Ferguson, stood with Malcolm while he was alive.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. A special greeting to the young people. It makes me feel good to see so many young people out here. The crowd seems to grow every year. It means that Malcolm means more to us as the time goes by and as we get older. And we hope to see the day come when this will be a black holiday.
That's right.
All for
black. Already black is, brother.
And all black over the world honoring heroes. I want you to take that message with you today. Those youngsters who are here today, you are going to grow up and you're going to take this place, or take the place of those of us who are older today. It's my pleasure to be with you again, and I hope I'm with you many more years to come.
Sure.
Stay strong. Where I come from, and I eat from there. Feel from there. Because ain't no
nobody going to move us just as nobody has moved them.
Right.
We're the children of Malcolm is in. But we have got to be here today, tomorrow, and many more tomorrows. These young people are an extension of our legacy. Thank you.
Black power.
Black power.
Black power.
Free the land.
Free the land.
Brother, sister, giving all thanks to the Most High, the God of our ancestors. Giving thanks to our elders who are responsible for giving us this institutionalized ritual of commitment and memory. Thank you for inviting us to be here, inviting us to participate in the modest role that we played by serving as your honor guard. And I want you to know, New Black Panther Party, soldiers of Khalid Abdul Muhammad, under the leadership of his designated successor, Malik Zulu Shabazz, are not just an honor guard. We are the New Black Panther Party for self-defense. I'm very proud to be in this army of young people that has produced leadership from within our ranks, based on how he was trained by Khalid, who walked in much the way that Malcolm did, like divine Allah to our right, my national youth minister. Like Brother Shaka Shakur, our chairman right here in the hall. I want y'all to pay attention to Brother Shaka, because he's right here in your midst. He's one of your sons, and he's doing good work with our babies on the street in a good, strong, red, black way. I want y'all to understand that. One thing I do want to say that's very important, I'm going to wrap it real quick. The red, black, and green, we are here because we are honoring African life for its sacredness.
That's right.
For its sacredness. There was an article about one of the assassins of this great brother. Somebody said that, well, you know, the man should be free from the system after all these years. He didn't kill the Pope. And I'm saying that to say that until we take and value our lives with the sacredness that it deserves,
right,
we will never get the unity that we need to create the power that we need, and we will never get the respect of the world that we deserve.
Make a point.
This was our leader.
That's right.
The Pope was better than anything. All those folks. You want to get under them trusses, you want to find centuries of shame, including the transatlantic slave trade, and all of them are famous for that. Hope, we got Malcolm. We had all of our ancestors, because all of African life is sacred, and we need to hold each other accountable for the sacredness of our life. And if somebody violates the sacredness of our life, get a hold of them as quickly as you can and put them on their black shameful knees and have them pray to the God of our ancestors for forgiveness and to have the strength to take and bear the consequences that they deserve. I don't care who it is. And I don't care what befalls me for saying this in front of you. I done caught some of the lead that took Malcolm out of here. And it doesn't move us backward, it moves us forward.
Right.
If a sacrifice will advance our race, then let the sacrifice be made. We're here for our faith.
That's right.
And they are the only future we have. And if we're not willing to pay the ultimate price for our future, then we're not worthy of any respect from anybody.
Malcolm X.
Stay together. It's all on our babies. And we are here until as long as necessary. And we'll see you in the world.
Free
the land, brothers and sisters.
Free the land.
Black power, brothers.
Black power.
It's certainly a great day to have all of you here, especially so many young people. And I've been coming here for years. First and foremost, we want to give thanks. Give thanks to the Creator for giving us another day to continue this great African liberation. Give thanks to the ancestors that inspired us to continue this great walk in the sun as Dr. John Henry Park epitomized. We want to give thanks for the spirit of Malcolm and Dr. Ben Shabazz, for whom just lost. We want to give thanks to those elders who have been in the forefront, and you see some of them here. And in the African tradition, you're not supposed to speak unless you ask permission of the elders. I done got so old, I forget to even ask. I have permission to speak. And of course, you have our first family of struggle, the Fergusons, who you heard from. You have our traditional African priestess and those who've taken the tradition and make it a part of their culture. You have Nana Ansah, who represents that. And then, of course, we have the grandmothers who have to take up the role of being the mother, being the special partner. And the sister Lori represents a Sankofa school that made my tradition. And then the Sankofa school has a special queen mother, Sister Ali McQueen. So you see our people here, you see the power of our doesn't let anything stop. She doesn't let the loss of sight stop. She doesn't let the weakness of the limb stop her. She'll be dancing to any drumming. And it's Queen Mother Jordan. Queen Mothers that are represented by Queen Mother Moore, the Queen Mothers that are represented by the Native American struggle, the Queen Mothers that are represented by our deep traditions in Ethiopia and the traditions in the rest of the region here. So we come as a great family. So I'm glad for all of you to see us here. We want to thank some special people, though. This brother don't like no special thanks, but none of this would happen. None of these traditions could be maintained. None of the spirit of ours could be raised as high as we have been without Hodge Omowale, Chief Commander of the Struggle, Professor James Smith. Yay! Yay. The sons of Africa, and to create with Professor Scobie a pan-African crucible at the City Council. This next year, 69, will be the 40th year of the struggle in 1969. And we in 2009. If we don't prepare something special to educate our people on the significance of struggle, using the City College experience as a base, transforming American education was the result of that great struggle. We have a mission to come together, and I'm asking you to come together. Contact Brother Small and myself so we can start the plan to make 2009 a special occasion for us to look at the revolution we've engaged in, look at the freedom of the African minds that we've been about, look at the liberation of reaching out to the African world that's been a part of what we do, and make it real for these youngsters. A person who's been a part of that struggle, who is here in spirit but not in his presence, but it is his partner that allowed him to do all the things he did with me, is a brother called Ambassador, His Excellency, Perez Kamanawere from Uganda. He came to America for an education. He bonded with a beautiful African sister from here, Carol Kamanawere. That's the sister who I'm standing in front of, this beautiful African queen. And she and her partner have stood by Brother Small and myself for over 35 years. We built the largest black studies program in the world. We have courses like Malcolm X and his time. 80 courses were put together. 50 of them taught every semester. 2,000 students in the class. 22 faculty, 15 of them tenured. The largest institution of educating black folk in an African way in the world was our creation. But it has been deconstructed because it was so hard. Now we have to be about a reconstruction. So that's why I'm asking you all to come together so we can start the plan. All of you who have graduated, all of you who have been attached to the City College, we need to come together and make this experience real. I'll be speaking extensively Wednesday evening at the Elks Plaza, the UAM, United African Movement, 7 o'clock, 7:30, you can hear me there. I'll be laying out some evening. Brother Small and I will be at another meeting, the Audubon, at 7 o'clock. Schaumburg, there's activity at the Schaumburg. There's activity in Brooklyn at the Restoration Plaza in Bed-Stuy. So there are activities that you can continue to be a part of today. I leave you with these words of empowerment. If there is no struggle, there is no problem. Those who professionally represent that, no matter what the crops are flying up and down, they want to rain it up with thunder and light. They want the ocean out to offer war on this many waters. This struggle may be a moral one, it may be a physical one, but it must be a struggle. Power conceives nothing without a plan that never did, never will. We have to go forth with that, bringing in our hearts. And as you youngsters go forth to do what you have to do in your school system, make sure you remember that struggle is key. Make sure you got to remember your sisters. I leave you with one important image, because image is key. Image determines self-respect, self-development. Image determines whether you're going to move in an arrested development process or you're going to move into a developmental process. Binding together the economics, your politics, and your culture. Ancestors speak to us. And a few years ago, I had a chance to go to
the Sudan to Nubia in 2004. A special pilgrimage. The ancestors were calling me there. I didn't know why the ancestors said you've got to go to Nubia. Over the years, they've been telling me you've got to go deep into the African Nile Valley, and maybe something special would happen to you. And sure enough, it did. I had a chance to meet that African spirit of leadership, of renewal, of brilliance that came out of this. And out of graves that our ancestors had created, they took the image of our leaders 2,700 years ago, buried them in the ground, waiting for a moment for them to rise. And this is the image I want to leave you with in terms of African power and majesty. The great struggles of African leaders in the Nile, the men and the women, the queens and the kings. These brothers came up out of the ground 2004 after 2,700 years to let us know that now is our time.
That's right.
Now is the moment. We have to take it and make it work for us. One last comment. We have a brother here who is a part of the City College family. He was a part of those students in 1969. He was on the white side of the struggle with SDS. But he's been on our black side ever since, taking cases to court, helping us continue this enormous struggle. And he's our attorney, Ron McGuire. Ron McGuire, let's put your hands in the air. We have a purpose in making it. It's the restoration of Africanness, the restoration of our place in the world. We stand first and foremost, it's African practice, African origin, African evolution, African cradle civilization. It's what we need to teach our people. Officials from the Ugandan